Okay, you have 10 minutes for presentation, and you have, I will ask maybe one or two questions, and I will give you some comments and advice. I hope that you will improve your PowerPoint before you do your final submission. So that's why I request you to submit your presentation after submit this PowerPoint slide after the presentation, not now. Okay, you can start your presentation now, please. Thank you.
Okay. Rania, you can start now.
Good morning, Doctor. We are Group 1, and our business model canvas will be presented by me, Nurili Rania, Shuwei. Next slide. To introduce ourselves, our company name is Digital Art. The type of business practicum that we will be doing is gig economy, where we will be promoting the production of customized digital art and logo with a range of unique, trendy, and aesthetic designs. The kind of industry that we are doing is art, and the type of service that we will provide is digital art services, where we offer customized digital art drawing and logo making services for art loving youths and startups. For instances, we will provide a range of designs such as the Kawaii series, Pinky Brush, Aesthetic Pastel, customized logo, and the perfect face. How we identify this idea? We did by observing the trends among youth in this digital era, and we see this as an opportunity that allows us to apply creativity and art into business. As you can see, this is our logo, which consists of the image Daisy and our company name. The reason for choosing Daisy is because it symbolizes innocence, simplicity, and joy to happiness, good luck, and new beginnings. As we are providing logo for startups, it is our best intention that this business have luck in their new beginnings. We also hope that our service can bring joy to our customers. Besides, in Victorian times, Daisy stood for loyalty and trust. With this in mind, we hope that our customers can trust us with good services. Next, the samples will be presented by Shuwei.
Hi, I'm Yong. Next, I'll present our samples of digital art. We are providing 5 series of digital art. First of all, is Kawaii series. We provide simple and cute design for our customer profile picture. We set up as 7 ringgit according to our advice from one of our key partners. For next is Pinky Brush. This shows the sparkles between line art and soft brush. This we set up as 16 ringgit. And third is Aesthetic Pastel. This is one of the soft and aesthetic style of drawing. Because of this cost, more detail on it, so we set up as 20 ringgit. And next is we provide customized logo, which we designing customer name or any words into a stylish logo. This cost 7 ringgit. And last but not least is perfect face. We provide a customer to show their perfect face in a perfect face ratio. So this cost 7 ringgit. Next I'll pass to our group member, Cassandra.
Okay, so now I will be introducing our company members. So first we have Siti Hajar as our sales manager. She's in charge in managing our sales and marketing strategies. And we have Nurili Rania as our customer service manager. She is in charge in maintaining good customer relationship. And then we have our production managers, Yong Shuwei and Rul Akmar. They are in charge in producing the customized drawings and logos and make sure they are in good quality. And we have our financial managers, Nur Ismira and Nur Tirunisa. They are going to manage our costs and revenues. And lastly, we have myself, Cassandra Aiman, as the general manager. I will be in charge in leading meetings and also coordinating all departments. So next, we have our 9 areas of business model canvas, our BMC. So the first one is we have our value proposition. So the value that we try to deliver to our customers will be first is the performance in our drawings and logos, for example, the aesthetics. And the second one is we'll be getting the job done on time. And then we also provide good service to our customers. And the customer needs that we try to satisfy would be customization. And the problems we aim to solve would be cost availability, where we provide multiple price points, just now like 7 ringgit and 16 ringgit. And then we also provide no added fees, like delivery fees. So for our cost structure, the most important cost inherent to our business model would be the tablets that we use to produce the drawings and logos. So we have allocated budget for unexpected repairs and also maintenance of these tools. And also we need internet data to produce the drawings and also to deliver it to our customers. And then we also allocated budget for distribution of commission among the company members. So for our revenue streams, our pricing tactics, as mentioned by Shuwei just now, is the time taken to drop to complete the drawing. For example, an hour for 5 ringgit, and our revenue model will be our commission model, and our source of income is our service sales, and the payment method will be mainly on online banking. So next, I will invite Shuwei to continue.
Thank you, Cassandra. Next, I'll discuss about the key partners, key activities, and key resources as well. We cooperate with an experienced digital artist who named Oyster Key for our advisement on pricing tactics. We also have support from our family members to give a tablet for us to complete our drawing. And also we have established digital art creators as our guideline and inspiration for key activities. We do some activities such as drawing, designing, providing customized digital art, dealing with customer marketing, promoting, and asking for their feedback also, followed by key resources. Yeah, of course, we use human talent in designing and drawing for customer logo and drawings. And next, we also use drawing software such as Sketchbook and Medibank Pen to produce our product. And we use social media such as WhatsApp and Instagram to promote our page. And next, also, we use Pinterest as our creative resources. Last but not least, we use Tumblr to produce it. Next, I'll invite Rania to continue.
Thank you, Shu. I will be presenting about customer relationships, the channel that we will be using, and customer segments. For customer relationships, to maintain and attract our customers, we will be giving more discounts as they purchase more services from us. We will also be doing bundle price when the customer buy from different series. Next, we will be doing promotions such as opening sale, later when we will open for orders. Other than that, we will be doing networking, which is we will be promoting this service to our peers, in which they will promote it to theirs to attain wide exposure. Lastly, we will be doing advertisement for our products in both of our channels. The two channels that we will be using is Instagram and WhatsApp. For Instagram, we have created an account which is at Daisy Digital Art for advertisement purpose and basic info such as our pricing list, samples, and other announcements. For WhatsApp, we will be using our working business number to the customer for further info and queries about their order. Finally, for our customer segments, we are creating value for youths who are using social media. Our most important customers are students, because most students own social media and they are attracted to aesthetics and trendy designs. Our customer archetype are students who love artistic profile picture and logo. Moreover, we will also be appealing to startups as they might need our logo making services for their new business. We have encountered four types of risks. Next slide, sorry. We have encountered four types of risks in doing this business. However, we have solutions for it. The first risk is that we may face the problem of time management, as we may not be delivering customized digital art on time as per request by the customer. To solve this, we can control the number of orders before the customer makes the payment. The second risk is that this type of business is challenging, as the marketplace for it is crowded with the same kind of services and it is competitive. I believe that we are able to work this out by providing an affordable pricing list that may appeal to those who is in budget while still in need of a high quality digital art. Next slide. The third risk is that customers may not be satisfied with the drawing and design. Hence, we will contact the customer to have a clear understanding of their demand before they pay for it. The last risk that we propose is technical issues like drawing not safe or delivery might be late. We had brainstormed and figured that we should provide refund and ask for customers' feedback. The rest of the presentation will be presented by Cassandra.
Thank you, Rania. So just in case if our business idea does not flourish, we have planned ahead three contingency plans. The first one is we will provide digital drawing tutorial services through Google Meet or any live presentation mediums. And the second one is produce the physical drawing, because we observe that people tend to like things that they can feel, they can touch, that they can see by themselves. So we plan to print the drawings into postcards or cards or posters. And the third one is the same concept as the second one, but we will produce things that can be used, like tote bags, mugs, or t-shirts. So in conclusion, we are Daisy Digital Art, and we are a company which aims to provide digital drawing and logo making services. We emphasize the values of customization and performance in order to satisfy our customers' needs. And our most important customers would be among the youth. So alongside hope for this business idea to flourish, we are aware of the risks that may come out from this idea. So we have planned out the possible solutions for each risk and also 3 contingency plans. So that is all from us. Thank you for listening. We are open for questions.
Okay, thank you for group one, a very good presentation indeed. Can you refer to the BMC that you showed me just now, the whole page of BMC? Okay. Yeah. Okay, thank you. So for your main customer segments are the students, right? But you also have new companies and entrepreneurs, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so when you plan for these two groups of customers, if you are planning for two groups of customers, then when you plan for your, because they are really different group of people, very different. So you have, when you plan for your marketing channel and customer relationship, you have to have different thing. Okay, so you, that means that for your marketing channel for students, maybe you get to them using Instagram, WhatsApp, because you know them better, right?
Yeah.
But if you are using the if you want to get into entrepreneur, then you have to think about that. Okay, you have to think about, what if I want to get to entrepreneur, new companies, then what can I do? What can I do? Maybe Facebook will be more relevant. Maybe, I'm not so sure. But for young adult like you, like 20 plus, 20 around 20, you are more using, you are more used to Instagram. But for elder adult like 30, 40, who might be the entrepreneur, then it might be Facebook. Okay, Facebook. So when you plan for your customer relationship and channel, you must have slightly different. Okay, because you have two very different group of customers.
Okay. Just
this is a little bit one. And then because you are talking about, you are doing designing of digital art, so it's very important for you to protect your artwork before you sell it. Okay, this is my personal comments, and I get this from your previous classmate, your senior who did this course, is they have some companies who want to buy their artwork. But at the end of the day, this company asked for the artwork and then they didn't pay for it. And they already showed to the company the artwork, but the company refused to pay for it. That's the problem with that. So it's good. You have to protect your artwork before they pay for it. For example, you put a logo of your own company on the artwork, you just show to them, this is something like this, but with my logo on it. So just to protect yourself, protect your artwork before you sell. After you sell it, they pay you the money, then you can give them the logo or the artwork with no constriction or better one than to the customers. Okay? All right? So I think you did a good job. Thank you very much. For one week time, you did a good job. Thank you. All right?
Thank you, Dr. Thank you for the comments.
Thank you, Dr. All right. Please improve your PowerPoint slide. Okay. I'd like to invite group two.
Okay, Dr. Sebentar ya.
Okay, boleh. Present dulu, coba tengok oke kah?
Boleh nampak slide?
Cep, nanti ya. Nah, atas sudah. Okay, good.
Okay, good morning to our doctor as well as fellow friends. Jadi kami daripada kumpulan 2, kami akan membentangkan berkaitan dengan BMC kami, which is kami ada 7 orang. Jadi next, introduction. Untuk introduction, type of business that we have already persetujui adalah berkaitan dengan untuk take order and delivering the order. And what kind of industry is involving food and beverages. And this is one of our idea, which is we are selling donuts. Dalam donut tu kita menjual pelbagai jenis donuts, which is including the classic donuts, bang bang donut, and pizza donuts. Selepas ini saya akan tunjukkan gambarnya. Dan juga kita ada menjual cendol dalam berukuran 600 ataupun 700 cc. Dan juga kita boleh ambil dalam pre-order lah. Jadi penjualan itu hanya akan diambil dalam bentuk pre-order dan akan dihantar sehari selepas pre-order. Next. Bagaimana kami mendapatkan ID ini adalah daripada consequences di mana kita mengetahui sebagai students, kita tahu bahwa donat yang macam di luar sana adalah lebih mahal berbanding dengan harga, jadi maksudnya objektif kami adalah untuk mengurangkan ataupun mengurangkan kos penjualan donat sebagaimana yang kita ketahui, kalau macam Big Apple ataupun Dunkin Donuts, dia harga dia mahal dan juga dia memerlukan COD yang mahal. Jadi itu adalah satu idea kami untuk menjual dengan harga yang murah kepada student dan juga ataupun ada juga student ataupun yang ingin menyambut birthday. Jadi itu adalah satu daripada sasaran kami, target untuk dijadikan sebagai sumber utama. Next. Oke, ini adalah contoh-contoh sample donuts yang kamu boleh nampak. Yang ada dua jenis tuh, yang itu adalah classic donuts yang biasa punya. Dia punya jenis adalah seperti Dunkin Donuts dan juga kita ada menu yang baru which is pizza donuts. But we don't have the bang bang donuts, we don't have the picture yet. But later on we will upload it on the Instagram. And next, so this is our logo. Consequences daripada kami menjual donut dan juga cendol, jadi kami sudah persetujui daripada kumpulan dengan membuat voting, which is we agree to with Chain Donut Hub. Ini adalah company kami dan juga kami punya slogan slogan company kami adalah Be Happy, Don't Worry. Next, saya akan serahkan kepada Mark. Adibah, maaf.
Assalamualaikum and good morning to Dr. and everyone. I will continue about the theme. For the general manager, Habibi will take the position. General manager, he will effectively act as scaled down CEO, overseeing the daily operation of a business segment, department, or standalone retail location. And Mark Jawe will be the sales manager. He will design and implementing a strategic sales plan that expand company's customer base and ensure its strong presence. Next, Equin will handle operation manager. She will manage the stock control and inventory checks, having a keen eye on budgets and budgetary change. Azmil will take marketing manager. He is responsible for company's marketing and communication strategies, as well as overall branding and image. And then we have QZ Mei and Jaya. They will handle financial, they will be as financial manager. They will perform financial function related to the collection, accuracy, recording, analysis, and presentation of business, organization, or company's financial operation. And lastly, Adiba, which is me, will be the customer service. I will retain customer and extract more value from them. And I will handle company issues in store, over the phone, and over emails. Next slide, please. So this is our business model canvas. I will present value proposition, customer relationship, channels, customer segments, and key partners. Next slide, please. So for our value proposition, the value that we to the customer is that the donut and the channel is affordable, tasty, variety of flavors, excellent service, like convenient to the customer, availability, and well-known brand quality. The problem that we're trying to solve is that we're providing our excellent service direct to the customer by their doorstep or their preference location. It will be convenient to them because they don't need to go out. The needs that we try to satisfy is that we will deliver the customer's order based on the location, affordable donuts with variety of flavors. Next is customer segments. The customer that we target are UMS students and 1B residents or anyone that live nearby. And also customers that are students. For the channels, for now, we decided to use. Actually, there's one more, which is WhatsApp. We decided to use WhatsApp for our friends and family members, friends and employment can help us to spread about our service to their own friends or family. It is still a discussion whether we want to use Google Form or from our WhatsApp group that includes customer and interested to use our service. Also, we are using Instagram and Facebook to use our service. This is the platform where we can reach more people, especially locals who are living near UMS. Next slide, please. Next slide. Oh, okay, thank you. For the customer relationship, we project to stay connected and by providing good delivery service and also customer acquisition and retention. Customer acquisition is like a set of technique that we use to manage customer prospect and inquiries generated by the marketing. As for retention, company or product to retain its customer over some specific period. So we will touch with our customer to be feedback. It is still in discussion. We might give maybe random gift or discount product when they purchase at larger amounts. It's still in discussion because we want to see how UMS students and 1D residents welcome our students. So we might conduct a survey to see what flavor that majority of them like. So as for the key partners, the first one is suppliers. The second one is business partner. Like maybe there's student in the UMS student that want to join our business, something like this. And the third one is family members, and the one is our friends. Okay, so that's all for me. I will pass this.
Hello guys, my line is have some problem. Can you guys hear me clearly?
Yes.
Okay, so I will continue for the presentation for the last few part of PMC. So the key activities for our company will be dealing with customer requests, marketing and promoting our products, collecting and delivering the requests, and last is the asking the feedback from our customer to improve our products and services. So the resources that stated Liba just now is we have human resources, which is from our suppliers, and also our team members will be the human resources. Not only that, we also have physical resources, which is a motorcycle. We can use it for delivery service. And we also have intellectual in multilingual, which is in Malay, English, and even Chinese, in Chinese Mandarin language, so that we can easier for us to communicate with different type of customer. So the customer base for us will be the UMS student and also resident at One Borneo, since some of our members is staying in UMS and some is staying in One Borneo, so we can separate it. We can deliver the food for these two places of customer. So the cost structure that we will need to run our company will be the fuel for transportation, which is I stated just now is the motorcycle. We need the fuel for transportation, the company model for us to run the company, and also we also need to have the packaging for our products, which is we might need to buy some box of packaging to package our product. And last will be the boost fee, which we will make some advertisement or something in the Instagram, which will cost money. So the revenue stream, that main revenue stream will be the service sales, and the payment method can be in online banking or cash on delivery, which we want when we deliver the food to the customer and they pay us on the spot. So what are the risks that we may face, which is first one is the MCO. Like now in the UMS already locked down for around 2 weeks, so this may be the risk that we can face. And another one is will be the bad weather, which is we will be very difficult to deliver the products when the raining day. And third will be the competitive marketplace, as we know that in 1B there is still a lot of beverage and food and beverage company that they may go to choose others than us compared with us. And the follow one will be the problem with supplier, which will be they may have the sort of flavors at the unexpected time, which we already ordered from them, but they cannot give us the product that we ordered. Another one is, all of us know that the chendol is a cool beverage, but which it cannot might not last long, so we need to deliver it on time so that our customer can enjoy the best form of chendol. So the following will be the last minute cancellation from customer, which is faced by a lot of F&B company, that the customer last minute cancel the order, which will we need to bear the fees that we didn't deliver it to the customer. And last but not least will be the customer might be decreased the interest after some time, which they might be bored of worrying about our donuts and chendol and want to try something new. So our contingency plan will be once, since that we also have another contact from another supplier, which is Man. So this might be a contingency plan for us to have a backup once we cannot sales the donut or chendol. So this is our reference for this slide. That's all from our presenting. Any question?
Yeah, thank you for the presentation. Okay, can you go back to your slide on VMC? Okay, very good. All right, here. Okay, let's look at your main customer segment first. Your segment is are students and 1B residents. That means you are referring to young adults, right? Young adults, okay. All right, she eat the birthday. All right, so when you sell the thing, affordable excellent service, okay, so it's okay, because when I see this is well connected, okay, so that's good. And then one thing is, your company is something very new, right? It's a new company, so you are more to attract the customers. If you look at customer relationship, your objective should be to attract the customer rather than to retain or to keep the customers. Okay, so your objective should be attract the customers, and then you think of strategies to attract the customers. Okay, you think of strategies. For example, you come up with a small sample, or you come up with coupon discount, whatever. Okay, so that is the only problem I see with your group. Other things I think is okay. And for your donuts, is supply from the outside suppliers, right? You get the supply. You're not only doing packaging, isn't it?
Yes, doctor. But we are kami sudah sepakat untuk macam guna dorang kami guna kami punya logo sendiri, which is once dorang guna kotak dorang, dan kami akan guna packaging kami sendiri dengan okay, logo okay. sendiri.
Oke, okay, maksudnya kamu dapat produk, kemudian kamu buat packaging sajalah, kan? Itu oke, okay.
Yeah, that's right. Salah.
No problem, actually it's better lah. Kalau buat begitu lebih mudah daripada kamu sediakan produk itu sendiri. Oke, okay? Dan kalau boleh kamu minta gambar donat yang betul-betul dari supplier kamu, oke? Okay? I'm not so sure itu donat dari supplier kamu.
Yeah, memang dari supplier, sebab as you can see here, donuts Mr. Mom, this is one of their product, tapi okay. lupa crop. Yeah, macam itu.
Oke, okay. okay, kalau begitu oke, okay. memang oke okay, sudah itu. Tidak ada masalah dengan produk. Cuma saya nampak cantik, jadi that is one question I ask lah. Adakah produk ini produk yang genuine?
Memang boleh, nanti kita bagi try, dokter. Nanti kita
okay,
bagi try.
Oke, kalau begitu oke okay, ya. Thank you for your presentation.
Boleh.
Alright, kumpulan seterusnya group 3. Okay, actually for group 3, they already sent me the video presentation. So to save a little bit of time, I request group 3 to show me your BMC only. Okay, I already go through your presentation just now. Video.
Okay, doctor, wait. Dokter, boleh nampak kah?
Oke, okay, boleh nampak. Oke. Okay. Alright, your kumpulan 3. Apa yang kamu jual tuh?
Kami jual cookies.
cookies.
Yes.
Itu kelepek pisang atau jual kamu?
Tidak, itu as a backup saja.
Okay, so your main product is cookies kan?
Yes.
Jadi sebenarnya apakah keunikan cookies kamu?
Keunikan cookies?
Yeah.
Oh, we sell it, kami ambil sulam, so we just guide the seller to be more kenal lah macam tu.
Okay, that's the question I ask. Okay, because when I look at your PowerPoint presentation, kamu kata kamu buat surat, but when I look at that, saya harap bah, sebab kamu ada kata pos laju, JNT, kalau sebelah partner sana, dan online shop. So if you are doing suram, you have to think, if I am doing suram, maksudnya you help them to digitalize the business, right?
Yes.
So the partner should be the company that you help them to do the digitalizing the business. And then what are the key activities is you help them to design their work. The key activities should be you help them to design their website. You have to help to prepare their advertisement kind of things like a brochure, catalog, things. Okay, should be your key activities. After that, remember your very proposition should is it cheaper price, convenient, or homemade? No, that is not correct, because your very proposition should be something related to what you are trying to help them. Okay, so semasa saya lihat PMC ini, pandangan pertama saya ialah anda dalam your thinking lah, pemikiran anda, you rasa you sebagai seorang penjual. So semasa anda membuat perancangan ini, when you do your planning, you are planning in terms of, oh, if I'm the seller, I do this, lah. Saya penjual, saya buat ini. Tidak. So if your main thing you want to do is suram means digitalize a local business. Itu yang kamu nak buat kan? So when I ask you what product are you selling, sepatutnya you bagitahu lah, we want to digitalize. Okay, which part you want to do? Marketing?
Yes, marketing.
Nah, okay, itulah yang sepatutnya kamu jawab. Jadi semasa kamu jawab soalan, semasa anda buat PMC ini, contohnya for customer segment, who is your customer then? Syarikat yang anda tolong buat digitalize, itulah syarikat kamu. Bayangkanlah, you have to think, I am the consultant. Okay, I am the advisor. I advise them, saya bagi mereka nasihat, saya bagi mereka cadangan bagaimana untuk membuat digitalize ini, dan saya menyediakan, tolong mereka menyediakan, katakan brochure, advertisement, gambar-gambar untuk ditunjukkan dalam internet kan, ataupun dalam Facebook, dalam WhatsApp tu, itu semua yang kamu buat. Okay? Jadi, so you have to get return hasil penjualan anda ialah dari segi pembayaran oleh syarikat ini. Berapa dia bayar untuk nasihat kamu, untuk pertolongan anda menyediakan produk menyediakan advertisement online dan sebagainya. Okay, guys, you understand what I mean?
Yes, doctor. Thank you, doctor.
Yeah. I hope you understand. For your group, if you are doing suram, you have to think it from another perspective. Bayangkanlah anda sebagai consultant. Okay, so what are you doing? So as a consultant, you are not selling the product, but you are advising them or helping them to design the things for sale or to design the advertisement kind of things. Okay.
Okay, doctor.
Ada soalan dari kumpulan tiga nih.
What if kalau kami change the from sulam to tech and delivery?
What I can see most of the thing is more for tech and delivery. Kalau kamu nak tukar, okay juga. Cuma itulah soalan saya. Apakah keunikan cookies kamu? You have to at least explain a little bit seperti kumpulan sebelum ni. Mereka menerangkan apakah keunikan produk. Contoh, if you want to change, Jadi okay, you. Okay, ya. Oh, okay, I give you some time. Untuk kumpulan tiga nih, I give you some time lah. You buat a simple discussion, perbincangan dengan ahli kumpulan untuk tentukan sama Anda nak teruskan dengan suram ataupun Anda nak tukar perniagaan Anda menjadi selling cookies.
Okay, doktor.
Okay, you let me know back lah untuk kumpulan. Okay. Kemudian ada perkataan, satu perkataan yang salah dalam di bawah cost structure. Modal ini BM tau. Modal BM maksudnya modal syarikat lah, maksudnya in English should be capital. Okay, that's the mistake I see. Alright?
Okay, doctor. Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you for group 3 ya. Group 4. Next group, I invite group 4.
Okay, doctor.
Sudah ada senarai link untuk attendance, tolong isi attendance masing-masing ya. Fill in the attendance now. Okay.
Dokter mau tanya. Kalau sudah isi di OBE itu perlu update di Google Form lagi ke Google Classroom itu?
Tak payah update di Google Form sudah, tak payah.
Alright.
Okay, thank you. Tetapi selepas pembentangan ini, Anda perlu hantar PowerPoint slide Anda kepada saya guna Google Form lah. Okay, saya bagi masa satu minggu untuk Anda hantar PowerPoint slide. Kerana ada kumpulan tertentu, saya minta ada pertukaran sikit. So, those who tiada masalah dengan PowerPoint slide, Anda boleh hantar sekarang. Yang ada masalah dengan PowerPoint slide, saya minta perubahan ke pertukaran tu, kamu boleh ada masa satu minggu dari hari ini untuk hantar. Okay?
Okay, doktor. Thank you.
Okay, kan? Group 4. You can start now.
Okay, thank you, doktor. Assalamualaikum and selamat pagi. So, kami daripada ahli kumpulan 4, kami akan membentang business model canvas. Ahli kumpulan kami ada 7 orang dan kesemua 7 ahli akan membentang pada hari ini. Jadi untuk isi yang pertama, iaitu jenis business practicum akan dibentang oleh Nur Muhammad Hafizan.
Sorry, yang slide pertama akan dibentangkan oleh saya, Kisansan. Lepas tu untuk jenis business practicum, jenis business practicum oleh kumpulan kami adalah take order dan delivery, di mana kami akan menerima pesanan melalui WhatsApp dan kemudian akan menghantarnya pada keesokan hari. Dan kami akan memfokuskan kepada makanan tempatan, iaitu makaroni Sabahan style dan buko pandan. Dan ini merupakan makanan yang agak popular dalam kalangan masyarakat kini. Oleh itu, kami telah memilih 2 menu ini sebagai produk jualan kami. Dan seterusnya akan dibentangkan oleh Hafizan.
Oh, okay. Industri macam mana yang akan kami buat untuk saat ini adalah industri yang berbentuk, yang berfokus kepada makanan. Yang mana kenapa kami memilih industri pemakanan adalah kerana tiga perkara. Yang pertama adalah keperluan, yang mana makanan merupakan sebuah keperluan asas kepada manusia. Yang kedua adalah permintaan, yang mana makanan berbentuk pemanis ataupun pencuci mulut ini berpeluang untuk berkembang lebih maju ke hadapan. Dan yang ketiga adalah gaya hidup, yang mana kebanyakan orang kesuntukan masa untuk menyediakan makanan di rumah ataupun kediaman, khususnya kepada pelajar yang tinggal di dalam kolej kediaman. Jadi produk ataupun servis yang macam mana yang kami jalankan? Jadi seperti yang Sansan ada terangkan tadi, kami menggunakan servis take order and delivery ataupun COD. Ini adalah bertujuan untuk memudahkan bagi para pembeli, dan dalam masa yang sama ini adalah sebuah mekanisme penjualan yang paling sering orang gunakan saat ini, seperti GrabFood, Foodpanda dan sebagainya. Dan dalam dan juga ini menjimatkan masa kerana pelanggan tidak perlu membeli secara bersemuka. Okey, seterusnya pembentang yang seterusnya.
Tadi saya akan membentangkan seterusnya. Bagaimana kamu mengenal pasti ada penyakit ini. Yang pertama kita akan berdasarkan faktor ekonomi. Pelanggan sasaran adalah pelajar universiti yang tidak mempunyai sumber pendapatan. Jadi kos yang terletak untuk membuat penyakit. Kita akan membuat penyakit dalam kos yang terletak. Bota adalah rendah daripada segi pembelian bahan dan sesuai untuk menggunakan bisnis kecil kecilan. Disebabkan oleh pelanggan adalah pelajar, jadi harga produk yang terlalu tinggi tidak mampu menarik minat pelanggan untuk membeli produk yang dijual. Next slide. Sebelumnya saya akan menggunakan kegiatan dalam bisnis dan syarikat kita. Yang pertama adalah Jack Nurudania merupakan Chief Executive Officer. Chief Executive Officer akan meneruskan keseluruhan operasi dan sumber syarikat. Selanjutnya adalah Jack Generally Valenti merupakan Human Resources and Administration. Human Resource and Information akan memproses data pekerja dan pengguru mengemas kini polisi syarikat dan membantu dalam proses pengambilan pekerja. Seterusnya adalah Jet Administration merupakan Financial and Accounting. Financial and Accounting akan bertanggung jawab untuk memeriksa, memantau dan menilai tugas dan aktiviti berkana sehari-hari. Dan seterusnya adalah Jet Muhammad Hafariza merupakan marketing director. Marketing director akan bertanggung jawab untuk memberi arahan, inginan dan kepimpinan mereka sebelah jawab dapatan pemasaran. Seterusnya adalah Encik Muhammad Hafizan merupakan marketing manager. Marketing manager bertanggung jawab untuk menguruskan promosi dan menunjuk kedudukan jenama produk yang dijual oleh syarikat. Cik Krisansa merupakan self-executive bertanggung jawab merancang, melaksanakan, mengurus dan mengawasi keseluruhan strategi penjualan syarikat. Dan akhir adalah Cik Emida Jensuk merupakan self-director. Self-director bertanggung jawab menguruskan semua operasi penjualan untuk organisasi dan perniagaan.
Bagi bisnis model canvas, di sini ada 9 part. Saya akan membentangkan 5 part daripada ini. Bagi yang pertama, untuk key partners, yaitu rakan niaga utama dalam bisnis kami, ialah pembekal, ya, seperti kedai-kedai runcit dan juga pasar raya seperti Pataras, dan dalam kalangan ahli kumpulan yang bertindak sebagai agents dan juga dropship untuk menjayakan bisnis kami. Bagi aktiviti utama kami pula, kami akan menubuhkan cafe sendiri, yaitu Pinnacle Dessert House, untuk keperluan memasak dan menyediakan bahan masakan. Seterusnya, mencipta platform pemasaran seperti Instagram, Facebook, WhatsApp, dan lain-lain untuk tujuan pemasaran dan penerimaan pesanan. Seterusnya, kami menggunakan sistem agent dan dropship untuk tujuan penghantaran pesanan kepada pelanggan. Sumber utama kami ialah resepi. Yang pertama, resepi itu sudah sedia ada dan diubahsuaikan sedikit untuk mencari kelainan dalam produk kami. Model kami adalah dikutip dalam kalangan ahli sebanyak RM15 seorang untuk tujuan pembelian bahan masakan dan lain-lain. Sumber seterusnya ialah kedai runcit atau pasar raya. seperti bataras untuk tujuan bahan masakan yang untuk dibeli. Seterusnya, kemahiran pekerja dan pengedaran. Kami menggunakan sistem agen dan dropship dalam kalangan ahli kumpulan untuk tujuan membeli bahan, memasak, dan membuat penghantaran. Seterusnya, media sosial untuk tujuan pemasaran dan menerima pesanan secara online. Bagi mengekalkan perhubungan dengan pelanggan kami pula, kami akan memberikan diskaun kepada pelanggan yang membuat pesanan dan juga memberikan jaminan pulangan uang atau gantian barang sekiranya produk kami tidak bersesuaian dengan keinginan ataupun mempunyai masalah. Seterusnya, kami juga akan follow up untuk mendapatkan feedback daripada pelanggan dan untuk mengetahui tahap kepuasan pelanggan daripada produk kami. Seterusnya, channels, kami menggunakan media sosial seperti Facebook, WhatsApp, dan IG untuk sebagai saluran pemasaran kami dan juga membuat COD. Seterusnya, Hatsupah Rizal.
Oke, baiklah, saya akan teruskan pembentangan, yaitu bahagian customer segment ataupun segmen pelanggan. Sasaran pasaran kami ini, kami memberikan keutamaan atau menyasarkan produk kami ini lebih kepada pelajar UMS yang tinggal di dalam kampus, kerana dengan harga yang kami tawarkan mungkin akan dapat memberikan peluanglah kepada pelajar UMS untuk menikmati kualiti produk kami dengan harga yang berpatutan. Selain itu, kami juga membuka jualan kami ini kepada orang awam, iaitu yang tinggal di sekitar Kota Kinabalu. Dan seterusnya adalah cost structure ataupun struktur cost. Yang pertama iaitu harga makanan itu sendiri, dan yang kedua kos pengantaran. Kami mengambil kira minyak, penggunaan minyak untuk membuat pengantaran itulah COD. Dan ketiga iaitu data internet, iaitu penggunaan internet semasa kami membuat pengiklanan produk kami, iaitu di laman-laman sosial yang kami ada seperti WhatsApp, Instagram dan Facebook. Dan revenue stream ataupun aliran pulangan, kami membuat dua cara pembayaran, iaitu dengan online banking ataupun pembayaran atas talian yang sering kita gunakan sekarang inilah dan sangat mudah untuk digunakan. Dan cara yang kedua adalah cash on delivery, iaitu pembayaran tunai selepas kami membuat penghantaran. Okay, next.
Untuk value proposition, kami sangat menitik beratkan tentang kepuasan pelanggan, yaitu kualiti makanan yang tinggi dari segi rasa dan cara penyediaan makanan adalah bersih. Harga produk adalah murah dan berpatutan, begitu juga dengan charge penghantaran, dan sentiasa mendapatkan feedback dari pelanggan untuk menambahbaikan produk sekiranya pelanggan tidak berpuas hati. Dan untuk customer segments, cost penghantaran adalah percuma sekiranya pelanggan membeli lebih dari 3 produk, pelanggan mendapat discount sekiranya membeli lebih dari 8 produk. Dan untuk penyelesaian masalah pelanggan, dan juga kami menyediakan servis penghantaran makanan. Open order dilakukan sepanjang 2 hari sebelum penghantaran, dan kami juga menyediakan khidmat pelanggan di mana pelanggan boleh bertanya bila-bila masa. Untuk risiko berkaitan idea perniagaan, risiko persaingan. Persaingan penjualan produk yang sama, yaitu makaroni dan buko pandan, di mana kami dapati ada juga pelajar yang menjual benda yang sama. Namun harga peniaga lain yang jauh adalah sama, dan maaf ada yang salah sini, kami menawarkan harga yang lebih murah lah. Dan risiko produk, adakah produk yang dijalankan mendapat sambutan yang memberangsangkan dan bertahan lama di pasaran, kaedah penghantaran produk yang digunakan agar cepat diterima oleh pembeli dan tidak rosak. Risiko kualiti, sukar mencapai sasaran kualiti yang disasarkan seperti kepuasan cita rasa pelanggan dan jumlah menu yang dijual adalah terhad kepada 2 menu sahaja. Okay, next.
Seterusnya ialah risiko yang keempat, yaitu risiko kewangan.
model dan kos operasi awal yang terhad untuk membeli bahan resepi dan juga bekas plastik dan juga minyak seperti yang Asfarizal cakap tadi, yaitu kos dari segi minyak kendaraan untuk menghantar produk kepada pelanggan. Ini semua merupakan risiko dari aspek keuangan untuk bisnis yang kami jalankan. Seterusnya ialah risiko pasaran, yaitu potensi penjualan produk, makaroni dan juga buko pandan untuk dijual kepada pembeli yang berfokus di kawasan sekitar UMS. Kawasan sekitar UMS ini termasuklah pada kawasan college kediaman di dalam UMS dan juga college kediaman usia masih lagi berada di bawah sekitar UMS. Seterusnya ialah kebolehpasaran dan daya saing yang tinggi daripada menu yang sama dilakukan oleh peniaga lain. Seperti yang dicakap sebentar tadi, mungkin berlaku persaingan dari aspek menu yang berbeza dan juga harga yang berbeza, dan ini menyebabkan risiko persaingan pasaran untuk produk yang kami keluarkan. Seterusnya. Okay. Untuk bahagian penutup dan idea tambahan, secara ringkasnya, company yang kami buka ialah, bisnes yang kami buka ialah Pinnacle Dessert Company yang merupakan sebuah perniagaan makanan yang berasaskan dessert atau pencuci mulut, dan dessert ini kami fokuskan dibuka, diambil sepanjang fasting month, bulan Ramadan yang beberapa minggu lagi. Jadi, peniaga ini disasarkan kepada pelajar yang tinggal di kawasan UMS dan pelajar yang tinggal di kediaman usia untuk membolehkan mereka membeli makanan tanpa perlu keluar rumah, karena kami akan menghantar dan COD terus order mereka, makanan yang mereka order terus ke depan pintu. Jadi mereka tidak perlu lagi keluar daripada rumah. Untuk idea tambahan, backup plan, sekiranya berlaku sebarang masalah atau pertukaran idea mengenai bisnes yang kami lakukan, iaitu makaroni dan juga buko pandan, kami akan berubah kepada idea tambahan seterusnya, iaitu nasi lemak pandan dan nasi kerabu. Berikut ialah contoh produk yang kami bincangkan untuk dipasarkan. Sekian, terima kasih.
Okay, thank you kumpulan ini. Boleh masuk ke balik kepada BMC, BMC kamu. Okay, alright. Untuk BMC ya. Saya cuma nak reconfirm produk yang kamu jual tu kamu sediakan sendiri ke atau kamu dapatkan pembekal makanan tu yang sudah sediakan sudah dimasak ataupun kamu akan masak sendiri?
Oh, produk yang kami buat ini kami akan masak sendiri. Kami beli bahan dan kami buat sendiri.
Kamu dalam kampus kah? Boleh kamu sudah ada kamu sudah ada tempat untuk memasak. Memang tiada masalah dalam menyediakan makanan ini.
Oh, bukan. Saya antara yang tinggal area luar kampus, tapi masih lagi berdekatan dengan UMS, dekat dengan area UMS, jadi senang.
Okay. Kalau berdekatan tiada masalah lah. Cuma saya heran kalau dalam kampus dia membenarkan ketika itu masalah. Kemudian kalau begitu dalam key partner, mengapa kamu ada agent dan dropshipper? Dropship. Anda faham apa maksudnya agent dan dropship? Ke? Agent maksudnya orang tengah antara pembekal dan penjual. Jadi kalau anda menyediakan barangan sendiri, if you prepare the things yourself, you sell it yourself kan? So you are not agent, you are actually the supplier and you sell it yourself. So anda bukan agent. Kalau dropship itu bermakna we get the supplier to, we are orang tengah, kita sebagai orang tengah, kita minta kita membuat jualan, oke? Okay? I sell a thing, tetapi saya tiada simpan stok. Jadi barangan yang saya jual tu, saya minta supplier untuk membuat penghantaran. Jadi saya seperti saya orang tengah lah, saya membantu untuk menjual. Tapi yang membuat penghantaran ialah supplier. Okay, nampak tu? So in your key partner part, saya tidak faham kenapa mesti buat agent and dropship. Itulah sebabnya saya tanya siapa yang buat membuat persediaan makanan inilah.
Okay, doktor, nanti kami betulkan, doktor.
Okay, begitu juga dengan key activity pun sama, agent dan dropship. Jadi key activity anda mesti termasuk membuat persediaan makanan, menjaga apa tu, membuat persediaan makanan, memberi bekalan dan sebagainya, mesti masukkan lah. And your key resources, sumber anda sepatutnya termasuklah seperti resepi anda, modal syarikat, okay, boleh diterima, but modal is Malay, okay. Jadi itulah saya okay, kalau kamu nak tulis dalam PM, tolong rujuk slide dalam PM, okay? You rujuk slide dalam PM, sana ada, you copy saja inilah words, the right words. Contohnya revenue ialah hasil, okay? For example, modal dalam PM kan? So your key resources modal, okay, boleh terima. Tetapi key resources sumber itu macam kedai runcit ialah pembekal, bukan sumber. Sumber ialah seperti your skill, kemahiran, your skill, your recipe, for example, these are your sumber, okay? Then if you have the, for example, you ada tempat masak, mungkin itu cara sumber anda juga lah, okay? So also in the channels, anda perlu terangkan sedikit bagaimana barangan ini sampai ke pembeli. Sama ada melalui penghantaran ataupun kamu simpan di satu tempat untuk your customer to pick up the product. Okay, so in your channel, you have to explain this lah. Okay kah kumpulan ni?
Okay, okay.
Okay, ya? Okay, kalau ada soalan, tanya lagi. Okay kah? If you understand what I mean kan? Jadi service penghantaran ini okay lah, dalam channel yes, but also dalam channel you boleh terangkan sama ada you ada pick up point untuk customer untuk datang ambil barang atau tidak. You can say that lah, okay? Alright, kalau tiada, saya akan jemput kumpulan seterusnya, okay kan? Kumpulan ni.
Okay, thank you, doktor.
So, thank you, doktor. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Kumpulan yang kelima.
Okay, doktor, wait ya. Alright, can I start?
Yes, you can start now.
Alright, so a very good afternoon to Dr. Adeline and also my fellow friends. So today, our group, Group 5, will be presenting our BMC. So as you can see here, our company name is Smartech and our business name is Student Hacks Clinic. And there are four of us who will be present today, which is me, Nava, Chong and Lim. Okay, next slide. Okay, a little bit of introduction of our business is, type of business practicum is virtual event management. And what industry is our business is actually related to education. And what kind of product that we are delivering is the academic tips. And how we identify this idea is based on our experience as students. All right, next. Okay, this is all the people behind this company, which is me, myself, as the founder or general manager, Muhammad Firdaus. And under me, there are three teams. First is marketing teams. Ayu Sahari as the marketing manager. Then Nava Rasan as marketing associate. And then the operational team is Lim Pejit as the operations manager, and Timothy as the operations associate. And the last one is financial team is Chong as financial manager and Melanie as financial associate. Next slide. Okay, this is the BMC board that consists of the 9 components. So I will just going to go this briefly because the other members will explain more about this later on. And first one, we will look at the value propositions. Our business is about online clinic that will teach and share the knowledge about some software hacks, maybe about Microsoft Word, Microsoft Open, and so on. And we have a variety of softwares that we provide. And our main focus is on university students. Okay, key partners is Google and Microsoft. Key activities, we will teach and share and also market our business through social medias. And key resources, we categorize into 4 categories, which is physical, human, intellectual, and financial resources. Our customer relationships is customer care. We have also virtual follow-ups through phone calls and so on, and also discounts for the early birds. And customer segments are mainly UMS undergraduates and also for the good savers, which is the students themselves, because our service is very cheap as 5 ringgit per person. And for the cost structure, we have internet data that we're going to use, and lucky draw prizes, as well as technology equipment. Channels to deliver our product is through Google Meet, WhatsApp, and also Instagram. And last one is revenue streams. The payment method will be online banking, and the revenue streams we get is from the registration fee. Okay, next I will pass this to Nava.
Okay, so for now we are going to see about the value propositions. So the value propositions for the product is divided into 4 elements, which is experience, benefits, and the futures. So the experience is true because we are conducting the hack online classes through our online, it's really convenient. The courses are conducted online. So there's no very high chance that everyone can attend. And the features is you can teach some hacks in using the online applications. And the benefits is the students can learn variety types of software that can be chosen to learn, because software is really crucial nowadays learning. And the service provided will be more focused on the university students, which is very specific about undergraduates. And for the customer, we divide into 3 segments, which is needs, pains, and gains. And for the needs, the ability to use the software during the learning process. And for the gains, as students can learn some useful hacks while using the software, and they can increase the efficiency and speed while doing their assignments and projects, and they can attend the course virtually. And for the pains, that there are students who face difficulty while using online software due to lack of skills, and most of the students cannot join such courses physically because due to pandemic. Next slide. And for marketing segmentations, we have 4 segments, which is demographic, psychographic, geographical, and socioeconomic. For demographic, we focus on undergraduate students, and for geographical, our focus is the students from University Malaysia Sabah. And for psychographic is the need to use online applicants to do assignments, and we want to increase efficiency in their works and studies and are a good saver. And for social economic, any social classes for students are most welcome into this online course. And for marketing channels is a way or technique used by the entrepreneur to deliver their products to the customer. So in this case, we use social media, which is FB, IG, to promote our business. And we also use Google Meet to deliver our class. Because why? Google Meet consume least data. So the usage of data is very least, and everyone can attend without any line problem. So this is why we choose Google Meet as our platform. Next. And this for customer relationship. And for the customer relationship, we communicate with customers through social media. Because of why? We want to get their feedback, and we want to have the follow-up with them. And we want to provide satisfactory service, and we appreciate to customers through follow-ups. Because of why? Because after the learning process, maybe some of the students have some doubts or they lack of knowledge, they something missed some points. So in this case, they can have a contact with us and they can clarify their doubts. So this is, we refer to the follow-ups, and at the same time, we can also receive the feedbacks from the customer so that we can emphasize our service more better. And we also provide discounts to early birds. That's all. Now I leave it to Chong.
Okay, so our key partners. So key partners is the relationship that the customer has with others, business, governmental, or non-consumer entities that help their business model works. So we need Microsoft Word because this is the applications to let us deliver the knowledge and skill to our customers. So the key activities, what are the actions required in order to make the business model work? Nature of the business is online clinic. So the key activities will be teaching, deliver new knowledge to the students to increase their efficiency in doing assignments. Next, sharing, provide some templates of presentation for the students so that they can create attractive presentation in class. And lastly, marketing, distribute the business among the students to attract participants and gain profits. So the key resource, the physical resources will needed is laptop and internet, and human resource needed is tutor and marketing team. And next, intellectual resources needed is knowledge and expertise amongst company members. And lastly, the financial resource is online banking. Next, so the cost structure. Actually, for our business, we don't really need any courses, but the biggest cost is the lucky draw prizes. And next is the internet data, because they need internet data to join our class. Mm-hmm. And lastly is the technology equipment, which is they need computers or any gadgets so that they could join our things. Next.
Okay, so now I will present about the revenue streams. The good value service are the value that our
stream, can you speak louder? I cannot hear you.
If like this, can hear clearly.
Very soft. Okay, you try.
But yeah. Like this, is it clear?
Slightly better.
Okay, so the good value service is the value for our customer to pay, and they are currently to pay for the academic information, and the online banking will be the way for the customer to pay. And for the last one is, how much does each revenue stream contribute to the overall revenues? If we estimate, if there are 50 people and each registration fee is 3 ringgit, and we might get 150. And next is, okay, next is, what are the risks related to the business idea? First is internet connection stability for both parties, because since the workshop is conducted online, so the internet is considered as an important factor. If there is a problem of internet connection, the backup plan is we will provide the participant with the recorded video so they can watch again that video. And then the second risk is, hackers might intrude and interrupt the program. To prevent the things from happen, we will send the Google Meet link privately to the participants. And the third one is, not enough participation to collect the profit. So to encourage more participants to participate, the work, we will boost our marketing strategies. And next, okay, this is the reference that this tree is the reference that we that inspire our group to make this workshop, like importance of computer skills in college, something like that. And next is the risk that really happened before this. And that's all from my group. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Very interesting idea. Okay, can you go back to your BMC as usual? Right. Okay. I think your idea is very good. And then just one question, I'd like to know, who will be the your trainer? Who is going to be your trainer? Are you going to get people to help you to train, or you do it yourself?
Based on our initial discussion, we are planning to be our own trainers. So means we ourselves will train.
Okay. Then the second question I want to ask: are you confident enough you be the trainer and people want to listen to you?
Because since this idea is only about hacks, which is the hidden features, so we will do a lot of research and information gathering through Google about these hacks and tips and so on. So I hope we have the confidence to teach.
Okay, all right. This is just something that in concern, because actually you can ask around if you can get some support from, I don't know, whether your lecturer willing to support you or not on the training. Okay, you can try to ask around. If you have lecturer who willing to help you to do training, or somebody who are really expert in, for example, Excel or in Microsoft Words, to help you to do training also can. Okay, also can. So you can think about that. Because if you are not very confident on the training yourself, right, people will not want to pay money to get the training. So it's very important. The first thing first is to get the trainer that people trust and willing to learn from them. Okay, to do the training. Is it okay?
Yes, doctor. Thank you.
Okay. So I think most of the things that you present is already quite detailed and very good. All right. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, doctor.
Okay, any more? The next group.
Okay, doctor. Wait a moment.
Group six.
Okay, sorry, doctor. My internet was quite slow. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so we are from group six. Yeah. We have. Okay, so we are from group six. Today there will be two presenters. In total, we have seven members. but only two will present today, which is me, Cindy Laina, and the other one is Muhammad Rifqi. Next slide. So we will begin by introducing our company and our product. Surprise Bee Nest is our company name, and Surprise Bee is a short form for the surprise box. The word nest, we relate it with our packaging method where we include shredded paper that has similar features with the nest inside the surprise box. Okay, so the picture, the beside picture is our model reference, and this is not our picture. This is we take this from the Pinterest internet. We put the link, include the link in the references already. Okay, so we call this as the surprise box or the gift box. Next. I would also like to introduce you to our team. The CEO of the company is me, Bindi Laina, Dennis Ijo. My production manager is Nicole De La Cruz. Our secretary is Lua Peng Li. Financial manager is Muhammad Rifqi. Our publicity officers is Rabiatu Adawiyah and Mawada Marja. And our sales and marketing manager is Jessely Felicia. Okay, so this is our job scope and responsibility. As a CEO, I oversee all tasks, understand the whole progress of the company, and help the team physically when it comes to the production. Okay, and then production manager handle the production of the product, which is the surprise box. Our secretary will handle documentation and arranging meetings. Financial manager will do a price survey for our packaging, which is the box. Shred paper, our snacks like chocolates and everything that we want to include in our surprise box. Okay, and then our financial manager will come up with the budget, create and keep price list, receipt, and etc. Our publicity officers handles social medias and design posters for promotions, our posts, and so on. Okay, and lastly, our sales and marketing manager will take orders, answer customers' questions, and any inquiries. Okay, this slide will be presented by Rifqi.
Okay, thank you, Dean. So now moving on to the business practicum where we officially focus on take order online and deliver. And what industry is more, we focus more on food and beverages. What kind of service and product? Well, we focus on snacks in the form of gift box. And how did we identify this business idea is by brainstorming and analyzing trends. Okay, moving next. Okay, now pass it back to Dean.
Okay, so for our business model canvas, we will start with the key partners. Who are our key partners? First one is supplier, which is one online shopping apps where we will buy our packaging, which is boxes, shredded papers, ribbons, and so on. Second is shops and supermarket where we will buy our chocolates, candies for the surprise box. And the second one is runner, where we will need to hire runner because not all of us are able to go out the house. Okay, so we will have to hire runner. Next is key activities for the surprise box is packaging, branding, designing, and marketing. Key resources, physical resources, stocks for the chocolates and all we need to keep stocks. Storage, we will pick one of our members' place, so then we can put our chocolates, our stocks, and everything at their house, okay? But only one members that lives in KK. And then human resource is our friends. Intellectual resource, brand partnership, as we will partners with other brands, hopefully, that also sell surprise box and gift box. Okay, and then our financial resources is from cash and credit. Key proposition: what value do we deliver to the customer? Food and beverage in the form of surprise gift box with affordable price and originality. For our customer relationship, how do we get to keep and grow customers? First is we do customization, meaning that our customers are able to choose what chocolate do they want to be, do they want to be included in the surprise gift box, or if they have anything personal that they want to give or they want to include in the gift box, they can personally post it to us and we can include in the gift box. And second is promotion. Channels, through which channels do our customer segments want to be reached? One is online selling, which is through the social media platforms such as Instagram and Facebook. And then the other one is WhatsApp. Our customer segments is for whom we creating values is we target customers that based in Kota Kinabalu. And our customer profile is university students and teenagers or young adults. Okay, our cost structure is marketing strategy, which is we need to pay for social media ads, for example, on Instagram or Facebook, and then our internet data. And then for delivery service, we need to hire a runner, and then cost per unit that includes packaging, the price packaging, branding, snacks, shredded paper, box, letter cuts, and scrunchies. And our revenue streams is for payment method is cash on delivery or online banking. And then our revenue streams are from gift box and advertisement sales. Okay. Next, I give it back to Rifki.
Okay, thank you, Lynn. So now for the risk and contingency plan. So we identify as a group with four risks, which is financial issues, human resources, competition, and unreachable areas due to MCO. So for the final financial issues, our contingency plans would be constructing good budgeting and cut loss if deemed necessary. Then in human resources, we will do task distribution among our members and having more virtual meeting for better communication, as well as recruiting additional human resources like runner, like what Dean has mentioned. And then competition will be focused on attracting packaging, provide best deals like free gift, and increase social media accounts and ads about our business. And for the, lastly, the unreachable areas due to MCO, we will provide better delivery service. Next slide. Okay, so in conclusion, we take this opportunity to enhance local economy in line with the National Entrepreneurship Policy NEP 2030, which is third, increasing the number of Malaysian entrepreneurs that are of high quality, viable, resilient, competitive, and possess a global mindset. Our product will help fully able to be to strengthen bonding and relationship through small gesture while satisfying one's sugar craving. That's it from our group. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, all right. Yeah, can you go back to your BMC? All right. Let's look at this. Okay, just one question. Your revenue from selling gift box, but at the same time, you have revenue from advertisement. So you are helping, who do you think you are helping them for the advertisement?
I think we only will sell, we put that advertisement sales because we will use ads to promote our business. So we are expecting our business will get a lot of incomes through the ads.
That means you help the companies to do advertisement, right? Is it?
Yeah, our company.
Okay. All right. So in that case, this sales of advertisement should be from the companies who are willing to pay for advertisement to advertise their product, right? So in that case, your customer segment should be related to this one. Because I can see is because the purpose of preparing BMC is all the parts of the BMC, the nine areas should be related. So all the sudden I see advertisement cost. Okay, as not cost, advertisement price. So I keep thinking, then who is going to pay? So I refer back to your customer segment. Then I see customer is the customers that you are referring to are the those like who are going to buy. So you expect them to pay you and you get your revenue from selling the gift box. So doesn't see the relation who is going to pay the advertisement sales here. Okay, so if you really very confident that you can sell your products, you can get payment for the advertisement, then in your BMC, you have to add one portion on this, okay, part of it. So in your customer segment, you have to mention how do you get this group of customers, who are the companies who are willing to pay for the advertisement. And then at the same time, how are you going to maintain the relationship with this group of customers? Okay, these companies, how are you going to get to them, the channel, and the other things, all right? For example, how are you going to relate your activities, key activities to this group of people? Okay, so you have to be very careful. If you have thinking of getting the advertisement as an income, then your customer part of this, that means customer relationship, channel and customer segment must be related to this. Okay, you have to include this.
Okay, doctor.
Okay, so if, let's say you think that advertisement sales is something that not that important and you want to just throw that away, it's okay, because what I can see, your whole BMC is about selling of a gift box. Okay, so it's up to you to decide. But one more thing is, I think when you think of your gift box, you have to think of gift box of different range. I see this is a market, but I see some people might not like chocolates or drinks, but they might prefer flower or a toy or a bear kind of gift. So you might have different things inside, but depends on how you want to promote your product. Okay, so you still can think about this. Okay, especially for the advertisement sales, you have to discuss with your group members, really reconfirm your products and so on. All right. Yeah.
Okay, doctor. Okay,
any question? Any question dari kumpulan ni? This group?
So far, no, doctor.
Okay, good. Okay, thank you. Thank you. I'll invite the next group, our group 7.
Thank you, doctor.
Kumpulan 7.
Can you hear me, doctor?
Yes, boleh. Okay, you can start now.
Assalamualaikum and very good afternoon to everyone. Our group BMC presentation will be about handmade macrame products. There are 7 of us, but only 3 will be presenting. There are items that will be talked about. First of all, our business practicum is take order and deliver. The process that will take place throughout our business journey are as follows. First, we will take orders via WhatsApp or Instagram, and then we will handmake the products before packing them nicely, and only then they will be ready for delivery. Next, the business industry that we are in is handicraft. We choose to be in this business industry because we want to support a rural business newcomer by selling and marketing the handmade products through digital platform. The picture shown is one of the products that she had sold. thirdly, the products that we will introduce to our future customer are ready and custom-made. The main products will be handmade makrame keychain. For your information, makrame can be understood as the art of tying knots in pattern. The makrame technique that we will be using to handmade our keychains is called basic square knots. For the ready-made products, there are two types of keychains, which are pendant keychain and bead keychain. Whereas for the custom-made products, there will be only one type of keychain, which is name keychain. That is all for me.
Hello. So we move to business ideas. Next slide, please. The product is very rare in Malaysia, in the market. So as I can see, that it is our best opportunity to introduce it to other people. And also, as you can see just now, it has a very old design and old style. So it will help us to remember our childhood memories. As you know, that kids really like to collect all the keychains, which is very beautiful and very cute. And lastly, we want to introduce our new product, which can be classified as gifts or presents that we can give to our friends as appreciation signs or maybe a birthday gift. Next slide. The next slide is our organizational structure. Let me introduce you our leader, Husna. And she will work with Shuhaidah as manufacturers. They'll be handling the process from the start, which buying the raw materials to deliver all the products. And next is Ghazali. He is our secretary, who is the one who will be jot everything important things that we discuss in our meeting. And also, he will work with Dinesh and also Fikri as a salesperson. Dinesh and Fikri also will handle our social media to promote our products to society. And lastly is financial manager, which is Hanis and Shafika. They will be the one who handle our budget and also in and out of the money to buy the raw materials or maybe other items. Next.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Dinesh, and I'll be talking about BMC today. Right. As you know, we are going to sell keychain, you know, as a reminiscence of our childhood, you know, bringing back all the old school trend back alive. And our key partners, not say key partner, actually, how are we going to deliver this product to you all is through delivery services such as like Shopee Express, Postlaju, and GMP. Our key activities will be like marketing our own product. That will be our very main objective because the more people get to know about us, the higher chances they might buy from us. And after that, there's the taking order and hand making the product, packing it and delivering it to our customer. And the value we hold is like any homemade, unique, personalized, affordable things, you know? Like when someone gets you a gift that is personalized and custom-made, you just feel special. You're trying to bring that specialness to everyone. And our customer relationship is very straightforward. We assist them personally, one-on-one, and they're very supportive. You can like contact them back anytime they want. And our customer segments are like our target group, to be specific, are like teenagers and young adults. This includes like university students as well, and the local. And the channels we're using are digital platforms, mainly Instagram and Facebook. And then we are gonna like try to talk to shops nearby. Are they interested? Would they like stationery shops especially because the stationery shops nearby school, if they are interested or not. And our key resources would be supplies. We need to buy all that raw material needed for that particular keychain. Our cost structure, very basic. It's cost per unit. It's just the raw material, labor, and all, and the postage as well. And revenue stream, you guys can pay through like online banking or cash to us. And yeah, pretty much that's it from me. Thank you.
So we move to the risk. Next. The first one is we know that our product is not in demand, especially in Asia, as it is very new. So the second one is we know that the product is not a need for us to have, but it can be wanted, as we can give it as a present to our friends. Personally for us, this handcraft has a very sentimental value. The third one is we know that this product has many competitors. So we only emphasize on our design, our product design, which is old style and old school, which we know that need to be maintained in the future. Next slide. So we move to the contingency plans or backup plans. We will change our product to handmade macrame bracelets or maybe phone straps. We can take orders, depends on what the customers want, what they request. And besides, we want to make a collaboration or merge with other business practicum to help the business. As example, we want to collaborate with Bail by Husna to promote the products in media social to be widely. In the conclusion, we think that these activities and the product actually give us opportunity to involve in handicrafts fields, which we know is very hot. And also it helped us to do some research and also observation on what is high demand product and also low demand product in the market, especially in Malaysia. And lastly, we hope that our product receive a very high numbers of requests from the customer, which help us to gain a lot of profits from it. I think that's all from us. Thank you.
Okay, can you go back to your slide on BMC? Yeah, okay. Just one question. When you say your customer segments are teenage, young adults, and local, where is your local? Did I miss something?
I mean like general public that reaches through our social media. That's what you mean.
Okay, you mean the whole Malaysia ka, or your location? Where are you? Your group, most of you?
We are in Semenanjung, KL.
Yeah, KL, right? So yeah. Are you referring to KL? That is when you say the word, but be careful. When you say the word local, it means a lot of things. Yeah? It can be Malaysia as a whole. It can be like if you are in KL, Selangor, let's say, Selangor as a whole, or where? Okay, so you have to be a little bit more specific. You have to be very careful when you say the word local. Okay, that's the first thing. Second thing is when you say channels, then you say digital platform nearby shop. That is my question. Nearby shop means that you are selling to the shop, then you expect the shop to help you to sell or what? Is that the meaning? Nearby shops.
For example, I'm going to ask help from a local shop owner.
Okay. Maybe you should say that you have a retailer or distributor to help you in selling. Okay. Then in your channel, then your key partner should include him as your partner. Okay, you include him also as your partner. So these products are handmade by your group, right?
Yes.
That is by your group then. Jadi, when you talk about let me see, because you change a little bit your format. Okay, when you talk about your key activities, the production of the things should be the most important thing also in your key activities. And so when you talk about your resources, the skill to prepare the product for sales, kemahiran, your skill, your ability to prepare the things for sale is very important. You must put in your key resources. Sebab itulah kemahiran Anda untuk menyediakan produk ini untuk dijual. Oke, dan puzzles, saya tak faham apa maksudnya puzzle. Oke, di bawah key resources. Itu saya rasa bukan sumber Anda tahu. Ya kan, bukan sumber kan? Puzzle ialah penghantaran kan? So, be very careful when you write your little bit things here. I can see a lot of things here actually. Okay, so when you build your customer relationship, remember you must make use of like social media kind of things to build your relationship. Okay, itu yang sangat penting ya. Alright.
Okay.
Is it okay? Ada soalan kan untuk dari kumpulan ini?
Not at the moment, Dr.
Okay, good. Alright, thank you. You don't have to worry. I think for handmade products, you still can find market. Okay, somewhere. Market there, market there. Okay, thank you for group 7. Then I call, thank you. Call group 8.
All right, doctor. Yep. Can you all see the screen, right?
Yes. You have to press the present part. The present at the bottom there.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Okay.
So good afternoon to Dr. Anou. So today Group A is going to present our business model canvas. So today we have three presenters with Jacqueline and Hanisa and myself. So here is our logo. Designated, I like mm-hmm. to explain our why we chose this as our business company's name. Designated, we use it as a hook, and also we want to highlight it as our product is something safe to consume with. And this is our tagline, pop the joy, which by not to pop in some popcorn that will bring you joys. So next, I will pass the time to Hanisa.
Okay, thank you, Grace. Okay, so for our business practicum, we'll be taking orders from online platforms such as WhatsApp and Instagram, and then we'll deliver it directly to our customers. For the type of industry, we'll be in the food industry, something that is edible. And then our products, we've decided to sell popcorn. Our popcorn comprises of three different flavors, caramel, chocolate, and gula apong. Okay, what makes our product special is the gula apong flavor, because gula apong is the specialty of our area here in Sarawak. It is a natural sweetener and healthier and less intense than white and brown sugar. It's rare food here. It's rare food outside Sarawak, but it's really popular here. It has always been used in small businesses like ice cream, traditional kueh, and drinks. But a gula apong flavored popcorn is getting popular nowadays. For our business idea, it is an unreplaceable snack of everyone's childhood days that can relive their past precious memories. Okay, so next, this one is our organization chart. Our president is Grace Lau. She will lead and manage the entire company's progress, including the employee. And then our accounting manager is Putri Sofia. She will be managing and overseeing the daily operations of the accounting department, including the financial data and reports. Our sales manager is Shabran. He will be designing sales plan and setting the sales quota and goals. Our sales supervisor is Jacqueline. She will supervise the daily activities of sales representative and recommends changes to current sales technique or procedures based on company's performance. Our marketing manager is Muhammad Nazri. He will be managing and creating plans on the promotion of the products. And then our advertising manager, Alisa, will monitor the product's promotion campaign and evaluate it. Lastly is our operation manager, Nurhanisah, myself. I will ensure that the company hits the growth target and sales goal. So next is another,
yeah. Thank you, Hanisa. So next for our business model canvas, first our key partners we have two is popcorn supplier and courier service. And our key activities are for to take the orders, packaging, marketing, and delivery. And our key resources will be human. Here's the thing, we decided to have our products to be in one place. And our team members will help to take the orders and package it to the customer which is in their area. And physical will be rely on the courier services, intellectual because we will buy it from the popcorn supplier. So it's actually a brand on market. And financial, we'll be using on the packaging. We will buy things to package our products. And next for the value propositions, we are going to sell the value of convenience because with the tap of your fingers, just a tap or text a message to tell us that you want to order. And second is safe to consume, and third, it's swift to people favorite. And for the customer relationship, will be our team with the popcorn supplier and the members of our vaccinated popcorn team. And here's our channels, social media, we were mainly on Instagram. Please feel free to follow us, and also on WhatsApp, and also the career services. Customer segments will be focused on youngsters and also sector people. For the cost structure, we'll be using our model to purchase the products from the popcorn supplier, and also the packaging fee. And moving on to the next, revenue streams. The payment methods will be two, online banking or cash on delivery. And for the revenue streams from, we will be giving discount for customers that buy a lot. So that's all for our business model canvas. Now I'll pass the time to Jacqueline.
Thank you, Grace. So for the risk, one of the risks is unable to deliver product on time. So to face this issue, we will choose trustable courier service company, for example, JNT, as this company has good review regarding their delivery service. Next, inevitable damage of product. To handle this issue, compensation will be given based on unpredictable condition to our customer. So in conclusion, vaccinated popcorn team will do our best to serve high quality product to each customer. Thank you. That's all from us. We are open for question.
Okay. All right. As usual, go back to your BMC. All right. So looks interesting. You are using a different ingredient in your popcorn, right? So I'd like to know, are you going to prepare yourself or how? Area, right? Some of the members not the same area, right?
Yeah, right.
So
actually we will buy it from the supplier which they will sell it, then we buy from there.
Okay, so meaning that with the ingredient, everything?
No, it already well packed and sealed.
Okay, well packed and sealed. So you are only doing packaging, right? Okay.
Yeah.
Right, okay, no problem. So your target will be someplace near Sarawak, your people?
mainly in Sarawak, but if for outside the Sarawak, then we will use the courier services. Of course, we will find the the reasonable charges.
Because you really have to think of if like the same popcorn, if you pack it and you courier it after 2 weeks, is it still nice? You have to think about that. Okay, or you just focus on selling in certain area will do.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. So I think your revenue stream, you have to bear in mind you have selling of the product is one thing, and then your discount will be given about purchasing. That one discount given should be from inside the customer relationship.
Okay.
Okay, in that one should be inside the customer relationship. That one should not be in the revenue. Revenue is from selling of products, or even you have delivery charges. Maybe you have to send to other places. Are that possible? Delivery charges. Okay, for sending to area a little bit far from your area. Okay, another small town possible. But not the discount is not under revenue. Okay.
All right.
Yeah. So I think that's all for your group. I have no more questions. Thank you for the presentation. Okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, next group nine, please send your slide.
Wait, madam. Okay, selamat pagi kepada madam dan rakan-rakan. Okay, ini adalah kumpulan kami. Di kumpulan kami ada 7, and yang akan present hari ini adalah 3 orang saja. Okay, first of all, kami ingin memperkenalkan kami punya nama company dan logo. Okay. Logo ini adalah berbentuk monster cheese yang melambangkan produk yang akan kami jual kepada orang luar. Dan Cezo adalah salah satu nama yang unik untuk company kami berdasarkan rasa dan kesedapan keistimewaan yang ada pada produk yang akan kami jual. Dan CO adalah nama company. Short form kepada company. Okay. Seperti yang kita lihat, yang gambar yang di sebelah kanan adalah produk sebenar yang kami dapat daripada supplier. Yang sebelah tu adalah supplier yang kami dapat dari Shopee, dan kami telah pun mengorder semua produk tu semalam memandangkan ada promosi dan tinggal hanya untuk menjual saja lagi. Okay, next. Okay, the type of business bagi company kami adalah take order and deliver. Dan industri kami adalah jenis industri makanan, which is food industry dari sila. And then what kind of product is cheese powder? Okay, next. Emily? Saya serahkan kepada Emily untuk presentasi seterusnya.
Okay, sorry. Okay, for identify business idea, we use 2 ways, that is observing trend and finding gaps in the marketplace. So number one, for observing trend is economy factor, which is level of disposable income and consumer spending pattern. For level of disposable income, it means the net incomes of the persons, the amount left over after the tax, debt. Okay, and next, consumer spending pattern is a data set that our business can use to assess market potential by geographically identify consumers who are likely to purchase specific product or service. And through this, we also can learn how much the consumers are willing to spend their money on common purchases. Contohnya, macam setiap orang akan consume product yang diorang mengikut cita rasa diorang sendiri. Then diorang akan stick to the product if they feel that the product is best for them. Macam cheese powder ni, especially for the cheese lover, diorang akan lebih prefer untuk beli makanan ataupun makan makanan yang dimasak menggunakan cheese atau mengandungi cheese. Sama juga dengan ada chocolate lover like that. Okay, then number two is social factor. Social factor which consists social and cultural trend. Kami melihat berdasarkan pengalaman dan pemerhatian kami terhadap produk cheese ataupun cheese powder. So sekarang ni semakin ramai penggemar cheese dan banyak kegunaan kreatif yang boleh digunakan untuk makan makanan bersama cheese. Contohnya seperti keropok, ayam goreng, fries, burger. It's mean can be topping for various type of food. Then the technology advance. Seperti yang kita tahu, banyak platform media yang boleh digunakan seperti WhatsApp, Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, YouTube yang boleh digunakan sebagai senjata untuk perniagaan kami. Dan features-features terbaru dalam S boleh membantu menghasilkan iklan-iklan yang menarik seperti sound effect, mukbang video dan sebagainya. Dan melalui online purchases juga seperti GrabFood, juga customer mudah untuk mendapatkan produk kami. Cara kedua iaitu finding gaps in the marketplace. Mengikut pemerhatian kami, first is lack of store resources that sell cheese powder product. Okay, ada pun yang menjual cheese powder product di kedai-kedai pun specific for the masakan, cheese for masakan. Number two is high demand from the public. Produk cheese sekarang ni semakin viral. And last, of course, we target for the cheese lover. Next.
Okay. Who is in the company? Siapa yang ada di dalam company kami? Next adalah Sean. Dia akan menjadi presiden kepada company kami dan dibantu oleh Vice President Natasha Lansi. And then saya Vivian David akan mengendalikan kewangan, keluar masuk, model dan analisis kewangan yang akan kami buat selepas jualan nanti. Dan marketing, sales and sales manager akan dikendalikan oleh Chris. Dan untuk sekretari and pembantu akan dikendalikan oleh Liana dan Richard. Dan bagi social media and advertising affair akan dikendalikan oleh Emily. Okay. Seterusnya, ini adalah 9 business model canvas area dan untuk bagian pertama saya akan serahkan kepada Emily.
Okay, for the key partner, we have buyer supplier relationships, which is the name of the shop is Dihijrah Powder Cheese Powder. From family members, friends, we can get support by helping we promote the product and of course our business partner. And then for the customer relationships, to build the relationship with our customer, example like such as we will up to date about the product, saving contact of our regular customer, keep in touch with them, get feedback from them. So untuk mencapai objektif ini, we provide personal assistance, memberships, and discounts. And last one, for our key activities, we will do product selling by promote or updates, receive order, packaging, delivery or post-test, and restock.
Okay, untuk bagian value proposition decision, and kami mendapati business kami ini nanti boleh menyelesaikan masalah kekurangan stokis dan memudahkan customer untuk mendapatkan order cheese yang kami akan jual. Dan untuk pengetahuan semua, cheese powder ini juga sangat affordable. Harga dia memang kamu dapat beli berbanding kamu beli di luar dan produk-produk lain. And then dia punya keistimewaan unik adalah powder cheese taste, dan dia punya tekstur tu, dia punya cheese powder tu sangat sangat mudah untuk kita blend ataupun brew lah. Jadi untuk bagian customer segment, kami akan memfokuskan pemasaran kami ni kepada cheese lover, dan seterusnya memandangkan kami datang daripada beberapa tempat area, contohnya saya dari Limbang, kawan yang lain dari Sibu, Seratok dan Kapit. Jadi kami bercadang untuk menjual produk ni kepada orang-orang di sekitar kami. Dan kami juga sebenarnya datang dari kawasan yang pedalaman, bukan dari bandar sangatlah. Mungkin ada di bandar, boleh buat di bandar, dan yang di pedalaman adalah sangat baik memberi kami peluang lah untuk mengedarkan produk kami ini kepada orang yang belum, orang kampung terutamanya, supaya mereka mampu, mereka dapat rasa juga produk kami itu. Okay, seterusnya produk kami ini juga boleh boleh diguna ataupun dijual kepada burger seller. Contohnya yang ada di sekitar-sekitar kita yang seller kecil-kecil punya, mereka boleh dapatkan daripada kami juga, dan tak perlu mereka susah payahlah. So means itu adalah satu kemudahan bagi mereka juga. Okay, cheese powder ni dia terbuka kepada semua usia. Maksudnya semua orang boleh beli, semua orang boleh makan, dan terutamanya kami memfokuskan kepada remaja lah, remaja ataupun budak-budak macam tu. And then benefit bagi cheese powder ni dia bagus dalam beberapa bahagian lah, terutamanya bagi mereka yang tak nak ambil heavy sangat makanan, dia boleh ambil cheese ni sebab dia punya, kami dah tengok juga dia punya produk tu, dia punya ingredient, dia sangat baik juga untuk kalsium dan untuk kesihatan yang lain. Okay, bagi channel yang akan kami gunakan untuk promote ataupun kami pasarkan adalah melalui social media, contohnya Facebook. Facebook adalah satu platform yang sangat luas sekarang ni, sangat cepatlah kita mau dapat order. Jadi dari sana kami akan guna Facebook ataupun WhatsApp untuk dapatkan order, dan dari sana juga kami akan sampaikan maklumat penyampaian dan macam mana barang tu boleh sampai kepada customer. Okay, thank you.
Okay, seterusnya merujuk kepada key resource, iaitu sumber utama. Key resource ni merujuk kepada bagaimana kami akan mendapatkan sumber utama untuk menjual produk. Yang pertama adalah capital, human talent. Human talent ni kami memerlukan kemahiran untuk berkomunikasi, untuk promote barang dan membuat iklanan produk. Seterusnya adalah networking. Kami memerlukan rangkaian untuk update online business menggunakan social media. Chris, previous slide. Okay. Seterusnya adalah financial dan physical melalui pengedaran stok secara COD atau postage. Okay, cost structure pula. di mana kami memerlukan kos untuk kredit, data, packaging, stock, delivery, postage, operation cost, dan cost per unit. Aktiviti yang memerlukan kos yang tinggi adalah untuk bahagian pengambilan stok. Seterusnya ada revenue stream, di mana untuk payment kami menggalakkan customer untuk membayar secara cash on delivery ataupun menggunakan online banking. Dan seterusnya untuk revenue stream, ini bergantung kepada penjualan aset iaitu selling cheese product. Dan jika produk kami mendapat sambutan yang baik, mungkin produk kami ini akan lebih meluas untuk melakukan catering. Sebagai contoh, kami berkemungkinan untuk menyediakan sos untuk food truck yang menjual makanan ringan yang sesuai digabungkan dengan cheese. Seterusnya adalah produk itu. Okay, next slide. Seterusnya adalah melihat pada risiko yang berkaitan dengan idea perniagaan. Risiko yang pertama yang berkemungkinan kami hadapi adalah melalui faktor sosial, iaitu perubahan tren sosial. Sebagai contoh, mungkin tren cheese ni dia cepat digantikan dengan tren-tren yang baru. Contohnya, tren minuman boba. Kami punya backup plan adalah mengembalikan semula tren sosial yang lama dengan menggabungkan tren terbaru dengan lama mengikut kesesuaian. Sebagai contoh, kami boleh juga membuat minuman boba itu berasaskan cheese dia punya pel itu. Seterusnya, risiko pertambahan penjual atau stokis. Kami bercadang untuk meningkatkan lebih banyak promosi, deal, iklan ataupun giveaway untuk mewujudkan persaingan yang sehat. Seterusnya adalah risiko sekiranya pelanggan berasa bosan ataupun muak dengan cheese yang kami jual. Jadi backup plan kami adalah untuk mengupgrade ataupun add on bahan-bahan yang colourful ataupun menambahkan ciri yang unik. Contohnya kalau cheese, biasa kita tahu produk cheese ni dia berwarna oranye kekuningan. Jadi mungkin kami boleh buat sedikit warna cheese itu bertukar menjadi warna yang lebih menarik. Seterusnya risiko yang kami hadapi adalah MCO area. Untuk ni kami bercadang untuk menggunakan perkhidmatan pos laju servis dan runner untuk menyampaikan produk kepada customer. Seterusnya. Okey, kesimpulannya, kumpulan kami mengambil peluang ini untuk memperkenal dan memberi peluang kepada setiap individu untuk mereka lebih up to date dengan trend makanan menggunakan cheese supaya mereka tidak ketinggalan untuk merasakan cheese produk. Dan harapan kami supaya dapat menyumbang dalam pasaran produk cheese ataupun cheese powder. Slide yang seterusnya. Okey, ini kami punya reference. Reference ini merupakan cheese statistik iaitu anggaran peningkatan permintaan cheese di seluruh dunia. Dan kalau sini kita dapat lihat dari tahun ke tahun anggaran dia semakin meningkat untuk permintaan cheese. Slide seterusnya. Ini merupakan kami punya produk retail. Dia punya kedai di Hijrah Cheese Corner di Shopee. Dia punya cheese ni halal dan dia punya expiry date lebih daripada 15 bulan. Dan kami punya cheese produk ni ship from Kedah. Slide seterusnya. Ini merupakan produk review daripada customer. Kebanyakan customer memberikan review mengatakan bahawa cheese powder nachos yang kami jual ini rasanya sama dengan cheesy wedges yang KFC jual. Slide seterusnya. Kalau kita dapat tengok produk review daripada customer ni, ada mereka berpendapat bahawa cheese powder ni sangat senang disediakan. Dia tinggal kena bencur dengan air panas saja. Slide seterusnya.
Okay, saya berhenti di sini dulu sebab.
Okay.
Thank you. Boleh pas okay. PMC yang itu. Okay. Untuk kumpulan yang lain, kamu tunggu sekejap selepas saya tanya satu soalan untuk kumpulan ini. Saya ada comments yang untuk semua kumpulan. Saya minta lah setiap kumpulan sekurang-kurangnya atau wakil beberapa orang yang tinggal tengah komen, kemudian kamu boleh ubah menempat baik slide kamu sebelum penghantaran. Dan penempat baikkan ini khas untuk laporan akhir itu. Okay. Saya balik kepada kumpulan 9 kan? Kumpulan 9. Okay, so untuk kumpulan kamu, produk kamu target utama untuk dijual kepada individu, pembeli ataupun penjual burger? Mana satu lebih dipentingkan?
Pembeli.
pembeli.
Kan, ini cheese powder kan? Tapi cheese powder ini bukan sos kan?
Dia powder, lepas tu lepas dia dibancur dia jadi sos lah.
Okay. Alright. Okay, begini. Kalau saya lihat secara keseluruhannya, your PMC ini lebih kepada kamu ingin menjual kepada individu. Tetapi dalam customer segment, saya nampak ada burger seller. So, burger seller, they are businessmen. So, semasa kita buat PMC, kalau our customers ada dua kategori yang berbeza, seperti yang kumpulan lain pun begitu. Kalau ada dua kategori yang begitu berbeza, then you have to, dalam PMC itu, masa penerangan tu mesti ada dua. Khasnya dari segi customer relationship and channel. Ini dua. Sangat penting. Semasa kamu melihat bagaimana you get to the individual customer, dan bagaimana kamu berhubung dengan burger seller ini berbeza. Jadi masa you buat customer relationship itu, you mesti ambil ini tactics lah, and then you have to have different strategy untuk dua kumpulan segmen pembeli yang berbeza. You get it? So if you say dalam customer segment, the benefit is to gain weight in a healthy way, dental health, ini bukan customer segment, ini saya rasa ini lebih kepada the benefit of product kan, bukan customer segment. Nampak tak? Bukan customer segment kan? Okay, your revenue stream, revenue ialah dari mana kamu dapat hasil, siapa yang sanggup bayar. So, from your revenue from selling cheese, okay, except catering. Are you sure you want to catering the cheese powder only? Okay, so you back to your product, back to your product. Adakah ini sesuai? Okay, adakah sesuai? Kemudian product review, adakah kamu akan mendapat bayaran untuk product review? Ini bayaran dari mana dah? Revenue stream from, maksudnya hasil anda dari mana? So you have to review back, check balik ini, bagian ini, mana yang kurang sesuai, kasih buang di bagian ni ya, revenue lah. Selepas tu kita balik kepada value proposition. Okay, I think not a big problem, but for your value proposition, the first one, solve stockist and customer problem. Itu pun saya kurang faham apa maksudnya stockist problem. Adakah kamu ingin value proposition ini ialah nilai yang kita bagi kepada pembeli. So, if you say stockist, siapakah stockist? Stockist ini rujuk kepada penjual kah? So, this is a bit hard to understand. Okay, sebab nilai ini khas untuk pembeli, bukan untuk penjual. Jadi, kalau stockist ini lebih kepada macam untuk penjual kah tu? Okay, maybe group,
macam pembekal, macam banyak stokis online kan, tapi tak banyak yang boleh sampai dekat orang directly macam tu.
So, kebaikan ini untuk pembekal ke atau pembeli?
Kepada pembeli juga supaya mereka dapat dengan mudah produk tu.
Okay, maybe your sentence ada masalah lah. Serasa guna ayat yang berbeza lah. Mungkin sentence tu yang berbeza. Okay lah, saya rasa untuk kumpulan ini saya itu saja soalan yang saya ingin tanya. Tolong cek balik ayat-ayat tu, perkataan tu yang supaya sesuaikan dengan business model. Lagi pun itu customer segment, you have to really look back mana satu customer segment yang paling sesuai untuk produk ini. Okay, untuk semua kumpulan yang tinggal sini ya, so I have to do a few wrap up, yaitu kesimpulan apa yang mesti diubah. Saya belum kasih tahu. Okay, the first thing is for the customer that is sorry, not the customer, the manager part, the management, the manager team part, management team part. I see many groups you have two manager for the samples. Katakan two marketing manager or two finance manager. You can't have that. You can have one manager and one deputy, timbalan pengurus boleh. Okay, you can have one manager and one deputy. So for your report nanti, laporan nanti, jangan ada dua pengurus yang sama. You can have one manager and one deputy. Okay, that's for the manager. Okay, the second thing for the format of PMC, I think just a few group, you change the format of PMC. Okay, that is wrong. You cannot change the format of PMC. You have to use back the format of PMC. Dan format PMC ini mesti kamu masukkan dalam laporan akhir. Okay, the table of PMC with all the simple details, very simple points must put in your final report. So the table must be correct in your final report. Okay, the third thing is when you talk about customer segment, okay, customer segment, be very careful of your customer segment. I just repeat that a few groups I have comment. If your customer segment only individual customers, then your strategy must relate to that. Your strategies in terms of your income and other things. But if your customer segment with two different group of people, one is the individual, another one is the companies or group, then you have to have different strategies for the customer segment. Okay, and then again, the second thing on the customer segment is, if in terms of choosing your customer segment, I explain four major factors. Remember, faktor pertama, first factor is demography. Second is social economy. Okay, geography. Okay, and lifestyle. So these are some of the factors. So you believe are two factor. Okay, you choose one of the factor to decide which segment you want to choose. If you choose demography, it's fine. You choose demography. So you can say I sell to students in UMS and student people probably near UMS area. So this is geographical. Okay, geographical. Then you can say geographically I sell to people who live and who work in this area. Okay, so that is customer segment. Next, I talk about in your customer relationship. Okay, customer relationship. For customer relationship, remember your objective. You can have to attract customers, to retain customer, and to keep loyal customer, to make sure customer become loyal. But for most, I think all of you are starting up a new company. So your main objective should be to attract customers. Okay, menarik perhatian pembeli untuk cuba membeli produk Anda. So you attract their customers, their intention. They never buy this product from you. So you assume that they are new, then your target should be attract customers. So when you plan for your customer strategies, okay, the marketing strategies, you have to have this objective. Objective ialah mendapat perhatian dan mendapat pembeli baru. Okay, that's your target. So your strategies should be related to that. And the last thing is for your risiko, your risk part, the risk. Every risk must have one, come with one suggestion how to solve the risk. Okay, some of you explain the risk, you didn't really mention about how to solve the risk. So every one, if you have three risks, then you suggest three solution and one solution for one risk. Maksudnya satu jalan penyelesaian, cadangan jalan penyelesaian untuk setiap satu risiko. Satu sekurang-kurangnya satu jalan penyelesaian untuk setiap satu risiko. Okay, so that is the small things that I hope you can improve for your final report. Okay, laporan akhir tu, your final report lah. For some of your slide, I say you please change, then you have to change. Otherwise, you don't really need to change the slide, and you can submit it using the Google Classroom. I have the link already in the Google Classroom. For those I say you need to change, you submit it within 1 week. That means by next Monday, before your class, you have to submit to Mia. Okay. So I thank you for all of you for your patience to stay with me. I have two more groups who want to do presentation today. So for the two more groups, please stay lah. For other people, it's free for you. If you want to stop, it's okay. Okay. So thank you for attending the class and for so patient with me. Okay. I have two more groups. I have group 10 and group 11 today. Okay. Group 10. Can you show me? Yes. Thank you. Group 10, can you show me your BMC? Group 10 already did their, already give me their video. So you just show me your BMC. We look at the BMC. Thank you very much. You are welcome. And then if you have problems because you are staying in campus or whatever, related especially to Abigail, you let me know. Okay, if you have problems especially for Abigail, because I understand you are in a very tough situation for those who are staying in campus. Okay. I think I got one question. Let me answer that question. From Wasna. Okay, Wasna. Fazana. Doctor, I have questions. We do collection in the video and like then we resubmit to you. Okay. So this one is group what? Kumpulan? Wasna, group 3. Okay, you don't need to do collection in your video, just that your slide, you need to do a little bit of correction and you just submit the slide. The video doesn't need to. Okay, no need for that. Okay, any more questions? Kalau the question you type lah, the kasana. Let me look at group 10, yeah, group 10. Group 10, I just want to see your, yes, this is the part I want to see because you already did your presentation. So to save my time, okay, I just look at your this PMC, will do. Okay, let me think, what is that? Okay, for your very proposition, I think you already have quite good explanation for very proposition. The one thing I have in my mind when I look at your presentation is, remember I asked you, if I'm not mistaken, you are the person you asked me about the product and organic lipstick. Then I asked you one question about, are you doing the production yourself or your friends who are doing the production? You remember the question I asked you? Ingat kan tu? I think can't remember your phone number, so I didn't. But I remember I asked you the question. Siapakah yang menyediakan produk untuk dijual? Siapa yang buat pengeluaran? So who is going to do the produce the product for sale?
Sorry, doctor, I forgot to on my mic. So it's basically we get the lipsticks from the supplier and we repackage it and sell, because the product is, the ownership of the product is from one of our members, which is Nuru Najwa.
Okay, all right. So be very careful when you plan for your key activities, because when you plan for your key activities, you remember packaging should be part of the activity then. Okay, because you say you only do packaging, right? Packaging, so your key activities should include packaging. That's the important thing. And your key resources should be recognition as modern, fresh, and reliable. Is it for the product or for the what? Your key resources, your capital. Okay, is the product well recognized, right? Then it's acceptable. Okay, maybe you can say the product is recognized, because you say recognition as modern, fresh, and reliable. I am not quite understand with that question, that sentence, okay, that phrase that you are using. Okay, so let's look at the key partners. So the key partners, your key partners should be cosmetic and supply company, or just the the company who supply the cosmetic to you. Is it the key partner?
Yes.
Okay, so it's fine. So your key partner is makeup artist. So it means that you expect them to help you to do promotion, the makeup artist?
No, doctor. When the new product arrived, so we already have a collaboration with a makeup artist when we do the photo shoot. The makeup artist will do the photo shoot, will make up for us to do the photo shoot.
Okay. I see. So it means that they are only helping you to do the makeup for the photo shoot. Okay. And then Insta famous and those, this is also for the promotion part, right? Okay, then fine. Okay, so social networking macam bukan dalam key partner. Social networking, is it under customer? And then you can refer that back. Only one thing I'm concerned with this is because it looks like a lot of things here, but it looks like also related to customer relationship. That is why I'm looking at this. Okay, but from your from your explanation, I know the makeup artist should be somewhere here, right? Okay, so when we talk about the goods, okay, the primary cost are the goods buying. So okay, that means the goods, the lipstick you prepare for sale, right? So the secondary cost are the product planning and marketing, okay, product packaging and so on. Okay, but in that case, right, in your risk, in your risk part, when you talk about, can you go to your risk? Okay, see, when you say talk about your risk, you say hard to find suppliers. This is the thing that make me have some question, okay? Hard to find suppliers because you say might suffer shortage of raw materials in producing the lipstick. Okay, you see the why I asked the questions just now, because kerana kalau kamu dapat memberi barangan itu dari supplier sahaja, jadi raw material is not your concern. Raw materials is the concern, okay, yang perlu dirisau oleh supplier kamu. Okay, bagi syarikat kamu ialah you just focus on you buy the product from the suppliers. Even though the suppliers are your friends, buy the product from the suppliers and you sell it. Okay, so if you say shortage of raw materials, itulah sebabnya saya tanya soalan yang pertama tadi. Adakah kamu mendapat produk atau apa?
What we meant about hard to find suppliers is that it is hard to find the suppliers from Malaysia to produce like organic products. So we have to find the suppliers from overseas to create the organic product for us.
Okay, you have to refer back your sentence. Might suffer shortage of raw materials in producing the lipstick. That is your sentence. You see that? Because your explanation is different from your what you explained. So that's why I will ask you the question about are you producing yourself or are you getting the products from somebody? Okay, you get that? Okay, sepatutnya ini patut dibuang lah. Okay, if you say hard to find suppliers, Okay, suppliers of what? Supplier of raw material or suppliers of the produced product. Itu berbeza tau. Okay, so if your supplier is the raw material, itulah memberi salah faham di sini. Okay, you get that? Boleh tak? Okay. Okay kan? Okay. Sebab ini ayat tu yang ada masalah. I will see that. Okay? Bukan saya nak sebab kalau saya berbanding dengan jawapan kamu di depan tu sama jawapan di sini memang berbeza. Itulah I think this is the problem. Okay? So for your group, I don't have other questions already. Okay? I think your presentation is quite good also. I have no other questions. Kumpulan kamu ada soalan mau tanya kah tu? Is it okay?
For now, no. But I'm a bit concerned with the because we have half of our students overseas, so we are just still discussing on sending the product to China.
Okay, actually, if this is the case, right, maybe you can focus on selling in one market only. Okay, I'm not so sure if products from overseas can import into China market. I'm not so sure you can do that. If that is the case, right, can they get the similar product for sale in their own market from their China market? That's the first question, if that is what you want to do. Second thing is, if this, the first part is not possible, that means they can't get the local supplier to sell the thing, okay? And they can't import to China to sell. Then the second thing I will say is, they have to help out in selling in the local market then. In selling in the Malaysia market. So those who cannot help in selling in the Malaysia market, they will do the promotion online, they will do the planning, they will do the preparation work. But the selling part is by those who are in Malaysia.
Okay, noted, doctor.
Yeah, you have to discuss and find ways to solve problem. Okay, so I know for your group is a bit challenging. Okay, so I hope everyone in your group are cooperating. I hope you hear and you understand that this is a challenging time for everyone. I understand that. So everyone must cooperate here. Okay, so thank you for your group for the presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you. I have one more group 11. Okay, guys, group 11. Are you ready? Okay, you can start once you are ready.
Okay, so a very good afternoon to doctor and to my fellow classmates. So we are from group 11 and our company name is Sweet Bites Cookie. So this is our group members. It consists of six people. And this is today's presenter. I am myself, Amanda, and will be joining me is Fazira and Elif Priska. So let's start. This is our table of content. We will start with a brief explanation of our business. Following up with that is our BMC, then our list, and the last one would be our appendix and reference. So firstly is our introduction. So this is our company's organization chart. Me, myself, is the general manager where I will be overseeing all departments. And then my secretary will be Elif Priska Justine. She will do any types of documentation. Moving on to our treasurer, which is Fazira. She will be overseeing company's budget and revenue streams. Our social media manager, one is the leader and another one is the Timbalan. There will be responsible for planning and implementing, managing and monitoring the company's social media strategies in order to improve sales and marketing. And lastly is our sales manager, which is Nur Aisha. She will be designing and implementing a strategy sales plan as well as analyzing trends and results. So what is our type of business practicum? We will be taking order and delivery. It is obvious that we are in the food industry and our product is called cookies with chocolate tips. So how do we identify this business? It is quite trendy right now, especially during quarantine. We like to eat food, you know, comfort food. So it is trendy but unique. So it is similar like the choco jar, but instead of the normal rice cereal treats with chocolate, it is a jar of cookie with a chocolate dip that customer are able to choose from. So moving on to our business model canvas.
Okay, I'll be presenting for the BMC. Okay, first for key partners, our stockists will be our first key partners is our stockists or supplier, which is from We Back For You, and our group members will be the agents to sell our cookies. And second key activities, we have product marketing, key stock and orders, delivery, and last one, problem solving. Third, for key resources, for financial resources, we have cash and online banking, division of all members, and second, for physical, is delivery. And oh, sorry, the quality is not, this typo. And the third one is publicity, which is through internet. We use Instagram and also WhatsApp. So for value propositions, first is functional benefits. So cookies and dip offers a delightful satisfaction to the consumer cravings, and it is not sold on a daily basis. We also provide the best cookies among local bakers. And second, for emotional benefit, choosing cookies and dip over others bring happiness to consumers as it is one of comfort food. And the third benefit, which is self-expressive benefit, cookies signifies a fun, stress-free, tummy feeling, enjoyable snack. So next is Fazira.
Okay, a very good afternoon. I'll be the doctor and everyone's here. So I will continue presenting the BMC. So for the customer relationship, we will use social media to do more engagement with the consumers. And other than that, we will offer special promotions on special occasion and also offer affordable price. And next, for the channel, we use social media websites like WhatsApp and Instagram. And we will also provide customer feedback platform for future improvement. And
The third one is customer segment. Our target buyers are to all ages, namely children, teenagers, and adults. However, we will focus more on teenagers who enjoy sweet and comforting snacks. And last but not least, we prioritize customers who value quality and reasonable prices. Next, Amanda.
So moving on to our cost structure. So as you can see, our selling price, as I mentioned before, the customers are able to choose their own chocolate. So for white chocolate, we will be selling it for 12 ringgit per jar, white chocolate 11 ringgit, and Cadbury. And Cadbury is for 15 ringgit per jar. And our raw material cost, milk chocolate is 7 ringgit, white chocolate is 6.50, and Cadbury is 9 ringgit per jar. So as we mentioned before, we are the resellers. Therefore, we are taking our first stock will be 20 jar. That includes 10 jar of milk chocolate, 5 white chocolate, and 5 Cadbury. That gives a total of 250. That is our gross profit. And our capital is 147 ringgit 50 cents, which gives us 102 ringgit 50 cents for our net sale. So our net revenue streams, due to the pandemic, all sales would be online sales and through various social media platforms. And there are a few types of revenue, which is a transaction revenue, recurring revenue, and delivery revenue.
Okay, so for risk of this business, first we have unreachable areas due to the MCO, second skeptical customer, and low demand.
Okay, for our contingency plans, we will provide postage services to cross certain areas while the MCO, and then we will also provide samples to the customers for them to try our product and to help them to make decisions. And lastly, in case we got low demand for our product, we will provide promotions by lowering the price or by providing free charge of delivery for certain areas. Okay, Nanda, next.
So as a conclusion, we are Sweet Bites Cookie that offers the best freshly baked cookies with chocolate sauce among local bakers, and our company hopes that we learn something new through this business opportunity, and hopefully our sales momentum will always run smoothly. That's all from us, and this is our pictures. You guys can follow our Instagram, and that is all from us. Thank you.
Okay, yeah, for your group, right? The product, you get it from the local supplier, right?
Yeah.
Okay, mine. Just go back to this one. Just wonder why you put your names of your group members here. Because the key partners, I keep on saying, they are like the person who provide, like your suppliers, your partners outside of the companies. So your suppliers, they are your key partners. Yeah,
okay.
Your suppliers are your good partners, not your friends.
Okay.
Members, right? And for the key activities, I think, do you do packaging?
Yeah.
Okay, so you have to add on your packaging here. Okay, I think the key resources, publicity is not part of your key resources. Okay, publicity, I think, if you say your skills in doing publicity, yes. Okay, skills in doing publicity kind of things, yes, but not the publicity itself, all right? Publicity should be something in a customer relationship kind of part of it, all right? Mm-hmm. And then the last thing is, when I look at your customer segment, and in your customer segment, first is you say all ages, children, teenage, and adult. And then more important to teenage. So which group is the most important group of customers that you target on?
I think teenagers and young adults lah.
Yeah, you better be more concentrate, all right?
Okay.
If you say teenage and young adult, then focus on that. Then next is customers who value the quality and reasonable price. Maybe you just focus on that, teenage and young adults. So if you say quality and reasonable price, I'm not so sure. Can you be very confident with who think that your product is of a good quality? Reasonable price, maybe, yes, because not so expensive. I don't know how big is your jar, but quality, people might have different opinion. So be very careful if you use this term. And one last question is, what do you mean by recurring revenue?
What do they call? Like model pusingan like that?
No, I don't think that is your revenue. Modal pusingan, modal pusingan refers to modal pusingan, the cash in your company, wang yang ada, wang tunai lah, tunai dalam syarikat, yang Anda boleh gunakan untuk membayar, membayar sebarang cost lah, yang kamu katakan. So that is, shouldn't be your recurring revenue. I think your revenue is from the selling and maybe delivery. That's all.
All right.
Selling and delivery. I think that's all the questions I want to ask. Okay. Any questions from your group? Anything you want to ask? Yeah. If no questions, then I will stop here. Any question in the chat? No. Okay. If no question, we just stop here. Thank you for the presentations. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. The last two groups. Yeah. Yes.
I want to ask a question. I am Najwa from Group 10.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, about, let me share my screen first. All right. Can you see it now?
Cannot.
Wait. How do I share this?
You have to click the word present now.
Okay. Wait. Okay, can you see my screen right now?
Yes.
Okay, for the key partners about the social networking, what I meant was we want to collaborate with the social networking like Instagram or Facebook, means that we pay them and then they will do a marketing for us.
Okay, I think the terms you use is wrong. You should be, it should be, I think they got one term, they call it internet celebrity.
Internet celebrity is mean that we use someone famous. This means that the Instagram or Facebook itself that promotes the things masuk ke dalam page someone that we don't know.
Okay.
Without so, it in our page account.
Okay. If are they people?
No, I think it's robot, I think.
Okay, you see, if you talk about social networking, that's why I say this is part of the should be customer relationship. Key partners should be people. If you say, okay, I'm using brokers, people who are very famous in Instagram or blog, they have many followers, you ask them to help you to do promotion, yes, they are your key partners. If you are not asking them to help you to do promotion, I keep on saying this social networking looks like you should put under customer relationship. That means how you're going to promote it. That's the part.
Oh, all right, right.
Okay, you get it?
Okay.
All right, good.
Thank you so much, Doctor.
Okay, all right. Any more questions? If no questions, then we just stop here. Any question you ask through the WhatsApp, thank you. All right. Sorry, I have another thing on at 2, so I need to stop now. All right, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you.
Thank you, Doctor.
All right.